So this is Mike's side, and I'm here with the Salonit. This is a European plane. It's made by Rock Borden in Slovenia. It's got a full carbon wing, single piece fuse, molded from carbon fiber. It's a 1K carbon, very, very light. I'm molded in a mold with the substrate being a white foam, not structural. The strength comes from the skin and the spars. These things can be built just a little north of 8 ounces. The tail group is a pull spring setup, very light. These are milled out of roacell, covered with fiberglass with carbon tow around the perimeter, the leading edge of each surface. It's a 2.4 compatible plane. Front is Kevlar with carbon tow, very, very stiff. The benefit of having a carbon wing is that on launch, there's no flex. Transfers all of your rotational energy into the launch. Very, very high launching airplane, very, very light. The airfoil is a modified Drela airfoil. It's been thinned. Very, very fast airplane. Penetrates extremely well. Flies very well without ballast, even in windy conditions. One of the reasons for that is the low profile. There's very, very little surface area in the front, very little drag, everything's enclosed. You don't have push rods hanging out, you don't have drag on the bottom, all the surfaces are very slick. On the tail end, nothing sticking out. Very aerodynamic, works with a stiff pull spring setup on the back. No flutter from the back. Can be built both with the top drive or standard configuration with the ailerons, as I've done here, or it can be built with RDS. This is the RDS setup. RDS mounts flush, and you can mount digital servos inboard without any servos exposed. This is the wing that I fly predominantly. Okay, we'll take you on a tour of the fuselage and the Salonit. It's very, very narrow. Choice of radio gear is very important. This plane was designed for 2.4. I'm using the AR500 receiver from JR. It's a 5-channel receiver with the antenna mounted with the receiving end just under the Kevlar. You can mount 2 digital servos. I've chosen to opt for a JR SM22 and an S185. The SM22 is used for the rudder. The spring in the rudder is stronger than the spring on the elevator, so a stronger servo is needed. It's very important to use a servo that has very, very good centering. Recommendation is to use digital. This is an analog servo, functions just fine. Digitals are going to give you a little bit better rudder authority, a little bit better centering. I have the switch jack mounted underneath the canopy. It fits right down between the 2 pull-pull lines. These are Spectra fibers. You only need 1. I've chosen a 65-pound test. It's overkill. Probably don't need much more than a 30-pound test. These run straight back along the length of the boom on either side of the ballast chamber. The ballast chamber is done kind of uniquely. You can do it a lot of ways. But what you can see here is you can see 3 carbon posts. These are posts that go up through the fuselage around the CG. The center one is the CG line. What's being used for ballast here are fishing weights. They're made of tungsten and they come pre-drilled. They're called worm weights. They've got a hole right down the middle and they slide right down on top of these posts. So I can set 1 weight here for light ballast. I can set 2 on the outside for medium ballast, and I can set all 3 for full ballast. You can ballast this plane from its 8.5 dry weight all the way up to about 11 ounces using tungsten, which is much more than this wing needs. So that's a tour of the Salonit's insides. The peg construction takes a little bit more than Kevlar because the skin and the wing is so thin and there's no blue foam substrate. You have to mount your peg with a couple doublers, as I've done here. Otherwise, you'll probably pull it out. But this plane is in the US, leading edge technology, as it is in Europe. Again, built by Rock Borden, and this is the Salonit.